What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here. And as we can see, Xelis has been on a tear lately, and I'm going to show you how to mine the crap out of it on both your CPUs as well as your GPUs. So just like when mining any coin, you're going to need a wallet to store your coin. So simply coming in to the Xelis website here, coming on over to resources and then clicking on wallets, we can see all the various wallets here. So we got the GUI wallet here, we have a CLI, we have a paper wallet, and the web wallet. So I just opened up a quick new web wallet, which we can see right here, and click on receive. Once you get your seed phrase and everything, copy in here. That is a simple way to get a wallet fast and easy. Next up, you're gonna need some mining software. And in order to mine this coin, we're gonna start here with CPUs. In order to mine with CPUs, you are gonna need the latest SRB miner. And if you plan on mining with your GPUs, you're going to need the latest Regal miner. Now, if you wanna use both, you're gonna need both miners. Now, starting things off in Windows with CPUs, once you do download and extract the latest SRB miner here, simply come into wherever you did do that and edit it. So we're going to right click here, edit this, and this will bring up all the parameters. So here you can see they have a whole bunch of backup pools and everything happening. I usually don't do that. I just get rid of them. You can fill those out if you want, but I'm just going to get rid of all of these right here, all the way to pool. So we're going to start with our pool here. And for this, we're going to be utilizing Hero Miners, which is the sponsor of today's video. So it's always recommended to choose the closest stratum to you. In my case, USA West. So I'm just going to copy this stratum right here, which I guess it already is. I'm going to right click, copy that, bring this up here, and then paste that in like so. Next up, we're going to need our wallet address. So I'm just going to get rid of this, and I'm going to bring up my web wallet here. Click here. It will copy it over, bring up my bat file, and paste that in like so, followed by a period. And then I'm going to go Rabid workstation. Actually, because I'm also going to be using my GPU, I don't want to mix them up. So I'm going to go Rabid workstation CPU. That way we don't have the same worker name kind of running on the same PC when we do our GPU side. So that's pretty much all we got to do here. If you do want to limit your threads, there is a command you can do, which I do have inside of my other bat file. So I'm just going to bring this up, and here you can see it's dash dash CPU dash thread space 30. So this is a 7950X3D in the workstation. It's a 32 thread CPU, and I do want to limit that to 30 threads. That way it's not using all my CPU and things get laggy and things like that. So this is what your bat file should look like. Once done, hit file and then save that. We're going to close this out and then simply double click on the one we just made. So right there. Now it should begin running the miner, detecting. Yes, it's saying detect GPUs. It's not going to run it. It will run it. And you can see now we're using 30 threads of 32 threads detected. Well, we are waiting for our miner to fire up here. Come back into the pool, scroll on down, and enter your wallet address in. That way you can make sure things are starting to get detected here. Hero Miners is usually pretty fast, and we can see here already, this is when I was earlier testing on, but we can see Rabid Workstation CPU is already up and running. It's green here. If I bring it up, we're just starting to find some accepted shares. So Hero Miners is very fast in detecting your rigs. All right, so while I'm waiting for the CPU to ramp up there, let's jump into the GPU side for Windows. And coming in, we're gonna need Regal Miner. Once you do download and extract the Windows version, simply bring up your bat file. That's the wrong one, so we're gonna close this out because it's still CPUs. Bring up where our Regal Miner is, scroll on down, you can see Xel right here. This is the bat file we're gonna need, so we're gonna right click on this, edit it, and this is everything we're gonna see. So by default, you can see how there's a whole bunch of colons and no colons and stuff. So if there's no colons in front of it, this is the line that it's going to run. So Hero Miners is in here by default. So I'm simply gonna come in here and I'm just gonna put bam, bam. That way it's gonna bypass this. I'm gonna come down to this one and remove those two colons like so. Now it's gonna run this command line right here. So I'm gonna come in and we're gonna get rid of our, this is DE, so we don't want that stratum for Hero Miners. Coming back into the mining pool and scrolling back up, I do want to copy this over again, USA West. Select the closest stratum as usual here, bring up our bat file and paste that in like so. Next up under dash U here, you see your Xel wallet. So we're just gonna get rid of this right here, and we're gonna come into our wallet address again, copy that over like so, and then paste that in here. Now we have a separate one here. We don't use a period for our worker name here. Sometimes I do find that you need both, and it sometimes reads the one after this. In this case, last time I used Regal Miner, it did work with just a worker name here, which it should. Anyway, I'm just going to come into here, and now I'm going to go Rabid Workstation GPU, which does have a 4090 in it. So this looks like everything should be good. At that point, I'm just going to hit File and save this like that. Close it out, but now we're going to want to do some overclock settings. So right here, I want to reset my GPU because that was previously Warthog settings. And now I want to set this up. We want to lock our core clock. We want to set an offset. And we also want, I'm going to go with a memory offset instead of locking it. You can try locking it at 5001, but you can also bring up more memory by setting an offset. I'm going to go 1000 on this offset here. In Linux, it will be 2000. It is doubled for these series of GPUs. Core offset of 300, and then I'm going to lock my core, I guess about 2400. I'm not 100% sure on that number, but that's what I'm going to try here. So I'm going to apply those overclocks, hit OK, bring up Afterburner just to make sure. We can see 2400. It's saying 810. Once we begin mining, it will jump up, obviously, here, but we're just going to make sure it's good. Everything's there. Now we're going to bring up here again and double click on Xelis here. And now this will begin mining with your GPU in Windows. So we're going to give this a little bit of time here. Again, while we're waiting, we can come back into our pool here and then just click on our address. It should be saved at this point, and it should be popping up very soon here. Let's hit a couple of refresh after you wait a second. We do need to send at least one share. So it does look like we did get an accepted share, and there we go. It's already popped up there right after that share. So now we have Rabid Workstation CPU, Rabid Workstation GPU, both mining away, which we can see right here. So now let's kind of look at our hash rates here. I don't have any power consumption because this is my workstation. I have a whole bunch of fans in there, extra RAM, and you know, an AIO, things like that. So we're using more power than a typical just straight up rig would. But coming into here, looking at some hash rates, we are currently around 53 kilohash on the RTX 4090, and it looks like our CPU is around 29. I do believe we're 30 kilohash on the 7950X when we don't have anything going on, like I'm not recording and have windows open and things like that. But we can see I'm also limited to 30 threads instead of 32. So that's another factor in the little bit of lower hash rate. But as we can see, the 4090 also costs twice as much as a 7950X3D build. Actually, a little less than that because a 7950X3D is pretty expensive. About twice as much as a 7950X without the X3D. But they do hash pretty much the same anyway. But, you know, in terms of hash rates, you know, it does make sense for the price between these two. And again, I'm not sure on the power consumption. Let's take a quick look at some profitability just to see what those numbers look like. So let's take a quick look at some numbers. 30 kilohash on the CPU at around 130 watts, I am guessing. It might be a bit more. It could be a little bit less here. 1% pool fee and everything. 11 cents per kilowatt hour, making about 66 cents a day now before power costs and about 31 cents after power. Now we're going to jump in and look at about 55 kilohash, if that's what the GPU was. So yeah, about 53, I guess now. So we're going to go 53 kilohash. Bring up Afterburner for our power. Again, software isn't really correct. We're not using that much power. Actually, there is a spike there. So it does spike from 180 upwards to 220 or something. Add an extra 10, 15 watts, I guess, for at the wall, power consumption, PSU efficiencies, and so on. Let's say about 240 watts. So I'm going to adjust that here, 240. And now we can see 66 cents and 31 cents. And now we're sitting at about $1.18 and 52 cents after power. So not too bad between the nice little mixed combo here. All right, that should get you up and running in Windows. Now that we got that figured out, let's jump into HiveOS. And I'm actually going to do this two ways. One, just for strictly, actually it's going to be three ways. One for just CPUs for CPU miners, one for just GPUs for the GPU miners. And if you have a combo rig, like a decent CPU inside of that and some GPUs like we do with some Wart rigs, I'll have a combo flight sheet as well to show you how to run just like we did in Windows with both our CPU and our GPU. All right, so let's start off with our basic two flight sheets here. So we're going to come into our HiveOS here. Make sure you are on the farm with your CPUs and GPU rigs. Click on flight sheets here. And then simply click on coin here and go XEL. Xelis should pick up here. So Xel, select wallet. I do have my GUI node, but we're going to add in my new one. So simply click on add wallet. And then I'm going to come in and copy my wallet address like so. And then we're going to paste that into my HiveOS flight sheet. Right there, we're going to name this. I am going to go Xelis web wallet. That way I don't get it mixed up with my GUI wallet or anything like that. And then simply hit the create button. Now it will be there with your other wallet as well. So you always know which wallet you have. For pool, we're going to come into here. Hero Miners is here by default. So that makes things nice and easy. And I am going to pick USA West as that is the closest option for me. It works better than Canada East, even though I'm in Canada. I'm going to apply that. And then for this one, we are going to select SRB miner. Remember, this one is for CPUs right now. So we're just going to click on that. Now we're going to name this flight sheet here. So I'm going to go Xelis CPU Hero Miners. Then we're going to come in and make sure everything is up to par. So it has, you know, Xelis hash V2, Peppy Pew here. We got our wallet here. Worker name is over here. Pool URL. Everything is looking good. We don't need to apply any changes. So we're just going to simply create that flight sheet. Once we did that, we're going to come up and repeat the same process, but set up our GPU flight sheet. So again, we're going to come into here, come into Xel. We got Xelis here. We already have our wallet in from what we just set up. So I'm going to pick my web wallet for our pool. Same thing. We're going to come into Hero Miners here, select USA West for me. It's the closest and lowest latency stratum. Here, we're now going to pick Regal Miner, which is right here. And then for a name of flight sheet, I'm going to name this Xelis Hero Miners GPU, like so. And then I'm going to create that flight sheet. Now we're going to create our combo flight sheet, a whole bunch all in one. So now we're going to come into here, coin and ticker. I am going to go Xelis, like so. Now I'm going to select my wallet again, Xelis web wallet here, select pool. I'm going to pick Hero Miners. We're going to come in USA West, apply that. We're going to come into the miner here. I'm going to put in SRB miner as my first miner. Now I'm going to name this thing right off the get-go here. I'm going to go Xelis Hero Miners CPU plus GPU. And now I'm going to add yet another miner. So here we're going to hit add miner. And now I'm going to put in Xelis right there. Wallet, we're going to pick our web wallet here. We're going to pick our pool, Hero Miners again, USA West, closest stratum. I repeat that endlessly, but just in case you're following step by step, nothing changes between any of these. And for the miner, we are now going to pick Regal Miner or Rigel Miner, however it's mentioned. Now, I do want to go into setup miner config just to make sure everything's there. It should be just like our other ones. Yeah, it looks good. So just cancel that out. And here, everything looks good. Just cancel that out. We got our worker names and flight sheet name and everything so we don't get nothing mixed up. Now we're going to create that flight sheet. Now we have all our flight sheets all ready to go, which we can see here. Easy to tell which one's which. And now we just got to run each one individually. So let's try them out. So we're going to come back into our workers, scroll on down to one of our double rigs here. I'm going to go with the 7950X here, rig 34. And I'm going to remove my current Warthog one. So we're going to unset this like so. And we're going to start with just our straight up CPU rig. So we're going to come down here, find our latest flight sheet. The latest ones you just make are right under your latest favorite one. And now we're going to see a Xelis CPU miners, Hero Miners here. I'm simply going to send that flight sheet to the moon like so. I'm going to SSH in, see if we have to download anything here. User one. Now we're going to go miner. And now you can see I do have the latest one here, but we are mining with our CPU like so. It's picking all 32 threads. It's connecting to the pool. We're just going to wait for a few minutes and let find some shares. All right, guys, so I'm glad this happened. I just wanted to point it out. By default, it's actually wrong when you set it up automatically like that. As you can see, the hashing algorithm is wrong. You guys probably already let me know in the comments, but Xelis hash V2 is the proper algorithm, but not the peppy one. This will actually, I was only getting like 4 kilohash or something. It was taking forever. I wasn't even finding a share. So what I actually have to do is come into the flight sheet here. That way, in case you guys have issues of just trying to set it up, maybe you got to this point and you're figuring out what's happening here. It looks right. Go into your setup miner config and just simply adjust this algorithm to Xelis hash V2, which you can see right there. So we're going to apply those changes and update that all workers. Now I just want to run in and do that for all the other flight sheets that I just did as well, because we are going to have to adjust that, or they won't work. So the GPU one, we're just going to come in, edit that, and adjust this. It's there by default. So Regal Miner was smart enough, but it looks like SRB Miner might not. So in our double one here, come into SRB Miner, and again, adjust this to Xelis Hash V2, apply that changes, update. Now our flight sheet should be good to go. And again, I could have just edited that all out, but I wanted you guys to show that obviously that by default would have ended up wrong. So now it does look like we're starting to gain some hash rates here. I'm just going to come in, look at our miner again, and we can see, yep, we're finding accepted result and shares and everything. We're going to come into the mining pool, and we can see now rig 37, 7950X3D. I got the worker name in twice accidentally here, but we can see we are detected at the pool. And we can see our hash rate, just like the 7950X3D in Windows, we're sitting around 29 to 30 kilohash here. So now let's move over and load up our GPU flight sheet that we did make. Here we can see the 3060 Ti. Again, we're gonna adjust our clock. So I'm gonna go 1410 on this GPU, 300 offset. And I'm gonna move this now, because we're in Linux, to 2000 on the memory offset. So I'm gonna apply those settings like so. I'm going to remove the flight sheet we're currently on, because we're going to go GPU only right now. So get rid of that. Come on down, find our flight sheet. Here we can see Xelis Hero Miner's GPU. So I'm simply going to hit that right there, send that one to the moon. And now we're going to load it up, and we should begin seeing this begin to mine now. So once the miner comes in a few minutes here, one of these days. There we go. So we're downloading the latest Regal Miner by the looks of things. And then once it all does doing its thing, it should begin mining here. We can see 1.9. There we go. Detecting the RTX 3060 Ti. So it's connected. Difficulties all set. Slowly starting to gain some hash rates. We should see a share here anytime. And then we should be detected at the pool. Now, in this case, I'm going to have the same worker name as I did on my CPU rig. So that's kind of the sad thing. You can probably adjust your worker name manually so it doesn't pull it, so you don't get confused. But if you're only GPU mining, it doesn't matter in this point. But here you can see successful share found. We got some hash rate happening, so everything is looking good on the GPU side of things. Now, for our one and final test here, we're going to unset this. And now, if you have a Warthog rig and you want to mine on both your GPU and your CPU, we're going to run our CPU plus GPU flight sheet that we did set up. So we're going to send that one to the ship now. Send up, going to the moon, rocket ship sent. We can see our double flight sheet here. One is using Regal Miner for our GPU, the other SRB Miner for our CPU. Now we're going to SSH into our rig, and we're actually going to use a different command here because we have multiple miners. So in this case, we're going to go MOTD space and then use watch. So we're going to enter that. Now what you can see here is up top, you have 1 and 2. So you can now swap between the two miners. So one, there's Regal Miner, there's back to SRB Miner. You can now watch both miners by using that command. And again, that command is MOTD space watch once you're SSH'd into your rig. Coming back into our miner here, coming out, going to the overview, we should start seeing hash on both sides. So now you can see our rig is doing 26.59. It should come up to that 2930 kilohash here over time. And now we're currently sitting at about 27 kilohash on the RTX 3060 Ti. All right, guys, so there you have it. That is how you mine Xelis with the latest pumps and everything, with the latest updated hardware on both CPUs as well as GPUs in both Windows as well as HiveOS. Hopefully this video did help you out. If it did, be sure to share it around. Hit that subscribe button to the Rabid Mining YouTube channel. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.